What's good, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk. Thanks for tuning into my channel. I greatly appreciate it. Take a quick moment, hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell, all that good stuff. You know, we drop daily videos, all different topics, but check it out, man. I want to get right into this Dame Dash. We've been seeing them in the headlines, and I tell you, man, they're trying to do Dame Filthy. You know, he's been speaking out against Chris Brown, this attorney, you know, that is basically, you know, what Dame's claiming and what it seems to be, you know, to me, is a conspiracy. These dudes are conspiring against Dame. They're playing dirty. And, you know, Dame just caught himself a W. He caught himself a win. You know, I'm happy for Dame because it's foul how they're trying to do this, man. Now, what happened is, this lawyer, Chris Brown, who you may have seen, I got, you know, a few videos up on the channel covering this stuff. If you guys, you know, want to check them videos out after you see this video, let me know. I can hit you guys with the links in the comments, or, you know, you could just find them on the channel or whatever. But this lawyer, Chris Brown, tried to file for a gag order against Dame, you know, because he's saying that, you know, Dame, the things that Dame Dash is saying in these social media posts on the gram, you know, where he's speaking out against what's going on and everything. He's trying to say, Your Honor, this, you know, could poison the jury in a future, trial, you know, like for a civil suit, you know, because we got different things going on here. We got legal battles, and Dame Dash, you know, what he's saying here, it's poison. But in reality, man, Dame's just trying to, he's just trying to, like, stick up for himself and fight back against, you know, what's going on here. Because it's a lot of people, you know, conspiring against Dame. But the judge said, nah, man, no gag order. And, you know, unless you prove your case. He's saying, you know, you can file again for this, but you gotta do better than this, what you're saying now. And it's kind of crazy, man. Like I said, they're playing dirty. I'm going to cover what they're, you know, all this. But it's foul the way people are moving. You know what I'm saying? Like, people, as we all know, social media is everything nowadays. It's, you know, they know everyone's on it. Everyone knows everyone's on it. So people use it in strategic ways, you know. And Dame's using it as a way to speak up for himself and try to expose what's happening to him. And these guys are like, oh, no, man, we can't have this. We can't have you telling the people what's going on. We can't have you sticking up for yourself. You're just supposed to take this, what we're trying to do to you. You know what I mean? It's foul, man. It's real foul. So basically, this is, I'm going to break it all down for you guys, right? There was this movie that Dame Dash, you know, was involved in business with other people, a director named Josh Weber, and an actor named Brian J. White. You'll see pictures of them all popping up on the screen throughout this video now. Brian J. White, you may remember this dude if you guys ever seen the TV show The Shield. He played Tavon on there. He was in Norbit. He was in Motives 2. If you ever seen the movies Motives, they're pretty dope. He was in Motives 2. And, you know, he's an actor. He's involved in this movie. When Dame Dash was working on this movie with these dudes, it was called The List. He invested a lot of money in it. You know, he says he provided like cameras and, you know, production equipment and things like that. They filmed a lot of it at his house. And then they tried to cut Dame out. Well, they did. They cut him out the movie. Now the movie's called Dear Frank. I don't know if it's out yet, or I don't know. But they changed the name on it and they said, yo, Dame, you're out. You put all your bread in. Now you're up out of it. You know what I'm saying? Dame put a couple M's into this that he won off another lawsuit. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy, man. And that's why I'm saying I'm glad Dame, you know, got this W in court. Because people just, that's what I'm saying, man. People hear that they can get over on you, you know, other people's going to try to get at you. You know, it's that whole thing, stick up for yourself. You know, and, you know, as people don't know, you're an easy lick, easy target. And no offense to Dame Dash, but I'm saying that's what these people must think. They must, you know, view him as being, you know, an easy victim or something, because they're all just continually trying to get at him. So anyways, they take the movie, they run with it. They claim that Dame Dash was showing up on the set high all the time, and, you know, he was late and things of that nature, so they had to fire him. And then Dame's, you know, battling it out with these dudes over this movie in court, right? Well, check this out. That's when Dame Dash got picked up on the child support when he came back to New York. And, you know, he got out, and then he went off on that lawyer in that deposition, Chris Brown. This is the same attorney that's trying to, you know, put in for this gag order against Dame, you know. And the attorney's just like I said, he doesn't feel Dame should be able to speak about this. Like, come on, man, get out of here, you know. That's the games these people are playing. So, you know, he's involved with that, with the movie and everything like that. And then now he's representing this woman, Monique Bunn, who's, you know, suing Dame and saying that he did some nasty things to her. You know, I'm not even going to get all into those allegations, because me personally, I don't believe them. Dame rolled the footage, exposed this woman that she, you know, basically tried to rob Dame Dash. You know, she had some pictures and some stuff like that for some kind of content that they were trying to put together, and she needed a hard drive. She showed up. Dame said, yo, go get you a hard drive. She bought a bunch of stuff and tried to come back and skate with everything that she bought, including the pictures and everything, you know. And then that's what Dame's saying. Oh, now this Chris Brown's guy's like, I'll represent you. We'll sue him for 50 M's. And like Dame said, they're trying to me too him and make him look like the Black Harvey Weinstein. Like, this is just foul, man. This is crazy, man. And that's, you know, when things happen with people, right? Two ways that's very easy to like discredit someone is they, you know, can try to put a tag on someone like they're, you know, he's saying, trying to make them look like the Black Harvey Weinstein, or, you know, they could try to make you look crazy. That's, you know, in the history of, you know, disputes and things like that, or people speaking out on things and trying to expose stuff, that's how people try to dirty up people's name. And that's what they're trying to do to Dame. And they try to put this gag order out, but the judge said, nah, man, I ain't rocking with it. But, you know, who knows? Maybe they'll try to appeal this and go to a higher court, you know, or the judge said, prove your case. Who knows? Maybe they'll try and, you know, I don't even know, man. You know, who knows with the way these guys are playing? They might try to, you know, bring in some kind of doctored up evidence or something and get the judge to side with them. But, you know, social media, like I was saying, is everything nowadays as far as, you know, what the public sees, you know. And Dame, in my opinion, is just trying to speak up for himself, you know. It's crazy, man, you know. And they're not trying to let him do it, but it is what it is, man. It's 2020, new year, and I'm just happy to see that Dame caught this W, because like I said, man, I've never, you know, I don't know, you know, I don't know these, you know, these people, obviously, but, you know, I'm a hip-hop fan. When the whole roc-a-fella split happened, the way everything went, you know, it was like, damn, you know, Dame kind of took a L there. Then later, you know, things that he tried to do in the music industry with other artists didn't really work out too well. Like, he had that Dash Music Group, you know what I'm saying? Then he had that lawsuit with that other dude, his name is slipping my mind right now, but I'm saying that's where Dame won that money. You know, he put money up for dude to make a movie, and he just tried to not pay him. So he wins that lawsuit, and then he rolls that money from that judgment into this, the List Dear Frank movie, and they're trying to get him again. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't know, man. You know, if Dame Dash were to ever hear this video, I doubt he ever would. Glad to see you caught yourself a W here. I'm kind of pulling for Dame. Y'all let me know in the comments how you guys feel about all this. Thank you for watching. If you're new to the channel over here on Jay Coffee Talk, we always want to hear what the people got to say. That's what this channel's all about. So tap in the comments. Let's talk about this. If you didn't already, take that quick moment now. It doesn't cost you nothing. Just hit that subscribe button. Hit the notification bell. We talk music, sports, news, current events, all kinds of stuff on this channel. And don't forget to hit that thumbs up like, y'all. It's Jay Coffee Talk signing out. I'll catch you guys on the next video. You guys have a great day. I'm out of here. Peace.